Lesson is on double entry system as a preliminary exercise. So, the accounting is a practice of recording the transactions. The accounting is done normally under two methods. One is single entry system. And the double entry system. Under single entry system, one part of the transactions are only be recorded. It is only feasible where business transactions are very limited, the volume of the business is so limited. But the other one is the double entry system. The double entry system considers two parts of the transaction. Basically, this double entry system works on the basis of dual aspect concept. Accordingly, every transaction consists of two parts. One gives benefit to the business. Others takes away benefit from the business. On those two principles, this system works. Then, all the transactions which are involved by the business are classified, and each transaction can be classified and grouped into two parts, and those two parts are recorded under double entry system. Then, under double entry system, since it consists two parts, it is a practice made by the accountant. To start this account double entry system, a preliminary exercise is normally be made by the businessman, which cannot be visualized in paper. Whatever his feelings, thought, views are only be presented on paper in format. So, to clearly understand the double entry system, this lecture will concentrate on what are the preliminary exercises required to start the double entry system. So, let us start with discuss this double entry system of preliminary exercise. Under preliminary exercise, the basic concept is each and every transaction is separated into two parts. Or else, for every transaction, two parts are involved. Those two parts are to be identified. That is the preliminary exercise needed by an accountant. Picking out two parts requires some practice. That practice is done in this lesson.
Oh, accountant may a preliminary exercise to identify two parts of the transaction into accounts. With this, the following 10 transactions were taken to identify the accounts of any transaction. The first one is investment made by the owner Ganesh into the business in cash rupees 10 lakhs. In this transaction, investment made by the owner, so it is investment and made by the owner and then he bought in cash. These are the paintings. Since the investment made by the owner, it is capital. The other one is cash. So, investment in the form of cash in it. Then, the second one. He brought the furniture worth of 2 lakhs into the business. Here, the investment made by the owner again, so that capital is one part, nothing but economic account, capital account. The other one is He made investment in the form of furniture. So, furniture and capital. Then, he purchased building and paid cash 1 lakh. Here, building is purchased. Here, building is purchased and cash is received. So, cash paid. Building purchased and cash paid. So, since it is an asset purchase, building's account should be in the name of accounts. Building is one part, cash normally paid, so it is cash. Then, goods purchased and paid. Here, goods are purchased, it is one part, and payment is made normally in cash. So that purchases, since goods purchases are made in purchases, and cash is the other part. Then, goods purchased on credit from 3 are 20,000. So here goods purchased on credit purchases. Anyhow it is in goods purchase, so purchases account. And the 3 is the person who provided the credit to us, so it is 3 account. So 3 and purchases. Then goods purchased from 3 and 4 and paid ₹50,000. So here goods purchase, so that it is goods purchase, so it is purchases, and even though it is appears a credit transaction, but indicates that cash payment of cash was made. Since cash paid, purchases along with purchases, cash is the other part. Then vehicle purchased and paid. So in this concept, entry or the transaction, vehicle is purchased, asset is purchased and paid. Vehicle is one part and cash is the other part. Then sales made and received 25,000. Since sales are made, sales is one part and cash is paid is the other part. And then salary is paid. It is an expenditure. Expenditure, since it is an expenditure, in the name of expenditure only, we have to consider the transaction. So, one part is the salaries, other one is cash. Likewise, rent paid to Ravi, the owner, 5,000. Even the Ravi is the receiver, owner, but it is in a rent to pay, is an expenditure. So that we should consider one part is rent paid, other one is cash.
An exercise is required to identify two parts of the transaction, and so that one could easily understood the double entry system in further steps. With this lecture on preliminary exercise on account finance double entry system is completed. For further details, you can go through that block.